Okay, so I haven't been doing a whole lot with the videos lately. Not that anybody's probably noticed, but you know, this is fun. So, but I was just gonna come do a little work on a new saw here. I picked up one of these Echos, which I said I'd never do, right? But the Echo 2511T, we've run it on a couple jobs, and at first, it blows, it sucks, right? So, first thing I did after a little test run where it absolutely sucked, like literally was bouncing in and out of wood, like had no torque, it sucked. Just took the spark arrestor out. That helped a lot. I'm in the process of advancing the timing. I'll show you all this stuff later. But one of the top thread on that crankshaft just barely rolled over and screwed me over. So now I gotta find a die. It's an 8mm fine thread, which is horrible apparently because you can't find them anywhere. So I'm just gonna finish correcting that, and I'll show you all that. But right now, what I'm doing is, I'm sure if you followed anybody with saws recently, and starting, I think this saw came out maybe 2 years ago, and immediately, of course, people start modding them. And the most popular thing that I've seen is, we'll port it, you know, we'll buff the intake and the exhaust side, port the mufflers, which all I've done right now. Drilled a little hole in that. That's all I've got right now. I'm gonna tune it like this first. When I have a little more time, I'll probably port the exhaust a little bit. It's hard to do on these because there's not a lot of material to remove in the first place. But we'll play with them later. But right now we got the spark arrestor out. The muffler is ported in a spot that I believe there's a baffle in there that directs the air out, around, and then down. Which is fine. Typically, I'd be like, no baffles, right? But this one, I think, is fine because it actually directs the air, and I've just given it a bigger escape. So to have airflow flowing where you want it is fine, as long as there's no, because it will actually help decrease back pressure. So creating a pathway for the air to flow is better than just squirting it into an exhaust, and then it creates back pressure before it can escape, right? So then the next thing is put a quarter pitch sprocket on there. That's a tiny little dude. I mean, like, even the steel MS-150s are bigger than that. But so all I do with these is I just use an impact. Probably guaranteed there will be somebody that will say I should not do it that way. But it comes off stupid easy. It's left-hand thread. It just pops right off. Here's the other one. This had, oh, I like that. It actually has like a little spot that captures the bearing. That's kind of nice. And we'll put that, so it's just got that washer in there. Put that washer in there and that captures the bearing instead of just letting it free float, which is kind of cool. So I don't know if y'all have done these or not, but then this is how it goes back on. Just like that, it literally just slides right in. You can't mess that up really. And then we'll put the clutch back in. And that's it. I'll show you that real quick. Let me make sure I got everything good. And then I'll show you that, and we'll put the bar and chain on and see what it looks like. Can't run it yet, obviously, because that thing got boogered up. Tell me I'm doing this wrong, but so it goes bearing, your sprocket, oops, down there, and then this washer. Then you put your clutch back on. It's just a centrifugal clutch, nothing fancy about it. It is left-hand thread, ta-da. So we tighten it to the left. Got all alive, and you're set. Like, I was a steel mechanic, and I have been trained in a lot of this stuff, and, you know, you probably should do it more by the book, but that's how I've always done it, and I've never had a problem, so I don't care. Put this bar J on here real quick to show y'all. I think it's going to be pretty cool, so. Dang, mosquitoes are coming out. Give me a minute. I'm not going to say it's a perfect fit yet, but that's what it's going to look like right there. This chain was just a touch shy. It wouldn't, I mean, just that much. It wouldn't let the tensioner reach the tensioner hole in this steel bar. So I'm pretty sure I understand the way that this one oils. So I was able to add a hole in the bar for the tensioner to grab that will also work as the oiler, I think. I could be wrong. If that doesn't work, then we'll figure something else out. It's not a big deal. I'll figure that out later. Tomorrow I've got the... I had to order a tap. I mean, a die. Because nobody has it. Like, I checked all over the city today. And even went to a local machine shop. They didn't have an 8mm fine thread die. So, probably need a tap, too, just so I have it. So I can try to use that same nut. Because this nut... it's just like the first thread on there started to get boogered up too because of that stupid thread. So one of those annoying little setbacks, but it should be fixed pretty quick. So we got a job in the morning we're going to go knock out, and then I'll be back to finishing this. But it's kind of cool. I like it. The saw is so light, it's ridiculous. And it was running better even after just taking that a spark arrestor out. So this, the muffler mod, tuning it up, I was able to advance the timing on this just the slightest bit. We'll advance the timing. So it's gonna be a little ripper. That's what I've seen most people doing. Like I said, I might port the transfers later, the intake and the exhaust, at least buff them. Take the slightest little bit of material out of there and smooth them out real good. And we should be really good, so. All right, so that thread that was boogered up on there, I got that fixed now. So now we're good on the crankshaft, the nut's fine, went ahead and pulled the flywheel, and on this one, like if you're looking at it, right, from the top, you want to take just a touch off that left side. That'll allow this to rotate slightly further ahead in the cycle, and it'll fire just a split second sooner. Alright, now, so we seated this back down on here, and you can see how it has a little bit of movement now. So all we're going to do is we're going to take this and twist it forward to the left just a touch, and we'll hold it in that position when we tighten this nut back down. So that will bring that magnet into contact with the coil just a split second sooner, and essentially give it just a head start on that stroke. Makes it a little better. Alright, well, I'm running out of daylight, but got it back together. I went ahead and started it up. It started up fine. It definitely needs to be tuned, but I'm not going to do that right now because it's dark and the bugs are coming out and I don't feel like getting eaten alive. But it's got some promise. It's a heck of a lot better than it was when I first got it. When I first got it, I literally was like seriously regretting buying it because it sucks so bad. Like, seriously, like, it's just out of the box. It was horrible. So, it's a lot better now. the quarter P chain, I think, is definitely an improvement because there's more teeth, but it's less drag, and it can spin that thing a lot faster. With the 3/8 P, those teeth just created too much drag, and then it felt like every third tooth was catching and bouncing and dragging, and it was annoying. It just would not cut smooth at all. Quarter P can pull that thing so much faster. So, and it's an 8 tooth sprocket as opposed to, I think this is a 6. Yeah, so two more teeth on the sprocket. Advancing the timing always helps speed things up a little bit. We ported the muffler. I may end up doing a little bit more. I kind of want to open it up and pull the baffle out and kind of, or even make my own baffle eventually, but that's all down the road. So y'all will see this in more videos coming soon. But as of right now, yeah, it's pretty cool. I think it shows promise finally, whereas before I was just disappointed with it. So we shall see how it goes. Anyway, thanks for watching, and catch you on the next one.